Welcome back! In today's video, I'll be showing you how to improve game performance and FPS on a Mac or MacBook. Most Macs or MacBooks won't necessarily be built for gaming, but if you do play games on it, hopefully some of the methods will help you gain a little performance increase or boost in FPS. The method should work on any Mac or MacBook running macOS. We'll be focusing on limiting the impact of background programs and processes, which should help free up some of the hardware to use in games. Remember to leave a like and feel free to subscribe if the video helps. Let's get into the methods. The first method to boost FPS and improve game performance on a Mac or MacBook is to close unnecessary apps or programs when you aren't using them. If you see the small circle below the app on the dock at the bottom of the screen, it means that app isn't fully closed. Make sure you fully close an app in order to prevent it from using the resources of your Mac. To ensure an app is fully closed, open it and first make sure any work is saved. You can use the keyboard shortcut of Command and the Q key to fully close it. You may need to hold down this key combination on certain apps for it to close. Let's move on to the next method. The next method is to stop some apps from running automatically when you start your Mac or MacBook. These apps might run in the background and use up resources. To stop apps from starting automatically when you start your Mac or MacBook, first go to System Preferences. You can get there by clicking on the Apple icon in the top left, and then by choosing System Preferences from the list. Within System Preferences, click on Users and Groups. It should be somewhere on the second row. In here, choose your profile from the list on the left. Now go to the Login Items tab. It will probably be next to the Password tab. You should now be able to see the list of applications that will run automatically when you start your Mac or MacBook. To stop a program from running at startup, select it in here by clicking on it once and then click on the minus icon. You can always add it again in the future by clicking on the plus icon and then navigating to where it is stored on your Mac. This will likely be the applications folder. Let's move on to the next method. Up next, we'll try and find out which apps are using the most resources. Once we find out which use the most, you can make sure that they aren't running next time you play a game. To do this, open up the Activity Monitor. You can do this by pressing Command and the spacebar, and then by searching for Activity Monitor. Within the Activity Monitor, look in the CPU tab and the Memory tab. In the CPU tab, the percentage on the left will tell you a lot about the app's processor usage. The higher the percentage, the more resources it's using. If you notice any apps that you aren't using, or that you can do without temporarily, then you can close them fully using the method mentioned earlier. If there are programs or processes that you don't recognize, it's probably best to leave them alone. The same can be done in the Memory tab, but by looking for high amounts in the Memory column. The next thing to try is removing unnecessary files and freeing up space on your Mac or MacBook. If your drive is close to or at capacity, then you will likely notice a drop in performance, especially with loading times. There are so many ways to free up space that I have a separate video that will show you 10 easy methods to free up space. Click the card on screen now to watch that video. To improve FPS, it might also be worth changing some of the settings in the game. You could try reducing some of the visual settings or the resolution. Have a look online for some of the optimized settings, as you may be able to squeeze out a few extra frames by disabling certain features. The next method is to make sure your device has sufficient cooling. It's very easy for MacBooks in particular to overheat, so try and use them in a well-ventilated area, and try avoid covering the fans. The final method to improve game performance and boost FPS on a Mac or MacBook is to update your device if you can. Running the latest version will help reduce compatibility issues. Also, make sure the game you want to play has the latest update installed. If you want to know how to update your Mac or MacBook, then click the card on screen now to watch my video showing you how to do that. And so those are my methods to try and help improve game performance and FPS on a Mac or MacBook. Click the card on screen now to watch a video of mine showing you 10 easy ways you can speed up your macOS device. We've already done a few of those methods today, so you should be able to zoom through that video for even more performance. Help support the channel by visiting the store, the link is in the description and at the end of the video. If you have any questions, then let me know in the comments below. And if you did find today's video helpful, remember to leave a like and feel free to subscribe for more tips in the future. Be sure to stick around to see some of my other videos that you might be interested in. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you in another video.